had a heck of a snowstorm. Most of the snow's still up in the trees, but it's tough going on a four-wheeler. I know a lot of you guys in the north, this is probably be nothing to you guys, but it's quite a mess. Reaper Militia Outdoors wanted me to make a video on how I do my cables. Here in Missouri, we got cable restraints. Which this is the first year using them. Actually, within a month, I just started. But I've caught a few coyotes already. And like most of the people that follow me, they watch Jason Engel, and he's out there snaring all the time. So that's kind of the premise I'm doing here. I got this is gonna be my first shot at a bait pile. So I got this trail made to my carcass pile here. And this might sound stupid, but get that sit on my boots and I'm just walking it back and forth here. Because anybody that's deer hunted has probably walked back to their tree stand after a snow, after they've walked out in the snow and they walked back and they got coyotes walking right on their trail. I've actually had it happen a lot over the years. They're not as scared of us. Well, they're leery. Like, I got a cat set with a flag up here, and you can clearly see where the coyote went around in circles. But they're definitely curious, and especially when it starts getting snowy like this, they're going to be looking for food. I'm trying not to destroy the whole area here, so. And I already know they're gonna, as soon as they find my tracks, they're gonna walk in them. So I will probably put cables on the farthest part of where I, like maybe I'll start here, stop here from now on, and I'll walk up and check the rest of my sets. So I'll put cables up that. But I will wait. But I've seen them do it several times. The last few snows, they walk on my tracks. Okay, you can't have anything over a half inch in the circle. So those guys are all probably good. But I wanted to put this guy back in. Like that. Hopefully this video is turning out. No entanglement. So I cut this off, just stuck it back in. No power rams here. I try to go, 10 inches, so I gotta get her a lot higher than that. Sometimes they're a pain in the butt. That's my pretty close to my 10 inches I like. I probably spend way more time on this than I need to. Okay. Right in the center of that trail. And with that scent on my boots, I'll bring it out here and hopefully I get them. Just go right to my bait pile. Or they'll be spooked right there. But I don't see that happening. It may take a little while, but right now they're looking for a path of least resistance because they don't like this deep snow. So, all right. I'll move on to the next one and show you what's going on. Thanks for watching, guys.
Welcome back, guys.
Right there. You can see those are coyote tracks going that way. They meet here, but there's also some deer coming through here. And the coyotes turned off here and the deer kept going, so I'm gonna come over here. And set my cable. Okay, let's see here. My spring's not locking on like I usually do. There we go. Thank you. feel like I'm just a hair out too far. That's a lot better, I think. Alright. Alright, guys. As I followed that trail a minute ago. I decided not to do that one down there. Right on the edge of a cliff. Okay, I'm just up a little ways from where I just set the last cable, and I got these coyote tracks here. They come back here, and looks like they... I'll have to investigate that closer. I can see pee, it looks like, from here. So, they look like they were running all around right here, but I'm gonna set one right here. I don't see any deer tracks. And then I'll go check that out. I might end up putting a foothold there. So let's see. I'll find a place for my bag. I'm sure this is better if you knew that the trails were here before the snow. Because now I've done walked all over the area, but if I don't get one soon, it'll be good for the snow that's coming up this weekend. 12 inch mark. Now, I'm gonna step way out and around that. Come on, damn it. See some deer fur here. Some turds. Lots of tracks. Boy, this looks good right here. There must be a dead deer back here somewhere. You can see he sat there. I wonder if they drug that deer into that canyon. I'm gonna have to check that out. Trying to decide. Something got drugged there too. I bet they got something in this canyon right here. Alright. I think there's probably a bunch of scent here already, but I definitely want to sit here. That's probably the hardest part of this whole deal, is figuring out where you want them. I'm gonna go check out back here and see if I can see anything. If I can find anything, I'll get back with you. But they've definitely drugged something along here. Okay, everybody, I went up there, drove along the, it's fairly deep snow here, drove all around up there, and I came back, and I'm gonna set this crossing here. This is not finding many tracks out here. These are deer tracks here. The ones I am finding are in the timber underneath these pines. So I know that they'll probably get on these tracks now. So I'm gonna set up on them, see what happens. too much wire here. Okay, let's see. I've been putting them two to a package to make it a little easier to manage them. Something to hide that wire a little bit. Something I don't like about them, I'll having to set them out in the open like this. But people swear by it. The few I've caught have been out in the open, so it's weird. I just feel like they would see it for sure. We definitely had too much snow. I'd rather have had just enough to see some tracks. You can definitely see what's going on under snow, but this much snow changes their movements. All right, stay tuned.